And welcome back to Blackie's Bulldog Tavern here in Smithfield. Mike Mancuso once again joined by head coach Mike Pressler. Coach, let's get right into it. The other semifinal game between Robert Morris and Mount St. Mary's in their earlier meeting this season. Robert Morris beat Mount St. Mary's 17-14. They were up big 16-8, but it kind of they closed the gap down the stretch there. Who do you see as having the edge in that matchup between the Mount and, of course, the Colonials?
Well, I think, you know, initially you go with the favorite in Robert Morris, but I got a lot of respect for Mount St. Mary's, Tommy Gravani, what he does. And Robert Morris has some offensive firepower, so does Mount. Right. And second time around, as you said before, tough to beat the same team twice in a couple weeks. I'm looking for that game to be really a battle. That's the first game, actually, at 5:30. Oh, okay. And then we play the 8:30 game against Quinnipiac. And, you know, I think 17-14, it wasn't as close as you would think. But that's going to be a toss-up. I look to Mount to rise to the occasion and really play well in this one, in the rematch.
And now, should you guys beat Quinnipiac, do you have any preference on who you'd rather play in the final, or does it even matter?
Doesn't even matter. I just... we just want to get to the final. You know, we want to do that. Quinnipiac obviously wants to do that too. Yeah. Two teams that both want the same outcome. It doesn't. You know, we don't think beyond that. You know, we're thinking about is Quinnipiac.
Right.
And you know, my assistant coaches will be up there to scout the first game, and whoever wins will be ready to go if we're fortunate enough to win.
Right.
To play them Sunday at 1 o'clock.
Yep. So Robert Morris comes into the tournament now the number one seed, 11-3, 5-0, NEC regular season champs. 6-game winning streak. They haven't lost since March. Their only losses this year to Denver, Colgate, and Bucknell. So all teams in the top 20. And they're the number one offensive team, as we talked about earlier. Considering the loss, though, just by one goal, how bad does your team want another crack at the Colonials this weekend, if possible?
Well, I think if from the players' point of view, maybe the kids are thinking that. From the coaches' point of view, I'm not thinking that at all. I mean, it's a heck of a work week for us, Mike. I mean, we got to get a scouting report ready for Quinnipiac, and then have one ready for Robert Morris and or Mount St. Mary's. So we got three scouting reports ready, three tapes ready to show if we're fortunate enough to get to Sunday. So this, for us, from the coaches' staff, is a lot of pressure on us in a five-day work week. To get all the preparation done, so if we are fortunate enough to win, we're ready to go whoever we have to play on Sunday.
Right. Now, we just mentioned you lost 13-12 just this past weekend to Robert Morris. You lost the ground ball battle, face-off battles by very slim margins. What do you think you need to do to turn those around?
Kevin Mass has got to play better. He'll tell you that.
Yeah.
And then for us, when we lose the face-off, we can't give him offense off the face-off. That's one. And we got to do a better job in the middle of the field ground ball, which we take a lot of pride in. I think they won that battle. And now after, you know, if we do play Robert Morris, if we do win on Friday night, you know, your question is, what do you change? You know, I think we have a much better feel for the personnel, you know, from a coaching staff and a player point of view after seeing them, if you see them a second time.
Yep. And now they do continue to have that Canadian trio that's accounted for 103 goals, and Kiel Matisse, Jake Hayes, and Dave Morton. So three guys that you obviously have to watch out. Second possible opponent, the number four seed in the tournament, Mount St. Mary's. They come in, the defending regular season and tournament champions. 5-8, though, on the year. 2-3 in NEC play. Kind of had a tough year. And they don't have any NEC wins over the other three teams in the tournament this year. All-time series now in favor of you guys, 3-1. And in your first meeting a couple weeks ago, you guys absolutely dominated them in a crushing 17-9 win. It was a blowout over at Bulldog Stadium. And you guys dominated ground balls 41-18 and the faceoffs 63%. You also outshot them 52-28. What were the biggest positives that you could take from that game?
That was arguably our best game all year, certainly offensively. And, you know, we have a great feel for Mount, as they do us too. Did a great handle on their key players, kind of kept them in check. Massa, you know, won the face-off battle. And then the bottom line for us is that into this tournament, you know, we got the best goalie in the tournament.
Yeah.
We got one of the top 2 or 3 goalies in the nation. So I think for us in the tournament, you know, to have that kind of as, quote, your X factor, and you know Jameson's going to respond. He's responded for 16 games for 4 years, and that's very, very comforting for us.
Right. And now, how difficult, again, is it to beat a team twice in a season? You might have to do it twice here if you wind up playing Mount St. Mary's.
Again, in a championship format. So, again, if you do get to Sunday, you know, that's what happens. Regular season, NEC, conference tournament, you're going to play the same team you play during the year. And then because there's only 60-something Division I teams, if you ever do make the tournament, the chances are you're going to play one of these guys again.
Right.
So we've done that for many years. So we don't really think about that. It's the exciting part, it's for a championship. You know, we're playing for something tangible. You know, a conference crown in the last year where we won't have the AQ. So there's so much riding, so much excitement. And as I mentioned before, a positive thing to send our seniors off on a very, very high note.
Yeah. And now, based on that first meeting in which you guys dominated, how much can you take from that game into this game if you wind up playing Mount St. Mary's? And how would you like your chances against them?
I don't think it's going to be, it can't be the same kind of scenario from the last game.
Right.
You know, we were, you know, we shot lights out, we defended them, we won the faceoff. Every category we won, I don't see that happening. And then, I've done this many times before in my old school, when you play Friday, Sunday, Friday's the coach's game,
right?
All the preparation. Sunday is the player's game. You got one practice, you've got an hour meeting, you show them some tape. You know, both teams are absolutely fatigued. You know, so it comes down to, it's a player's game. The coaches are out of it. And whose players can kind of rise up to the occasion and play better than the other guys? That's the beauty of our sport in a very short two games in 3-day format, a Final Four format.
And you did have that experience a couple of weeks ago when you took on Yale and then played Wagner 2 days later. So you have had that towards the tail end of your season. Perhaps could be some good momentum heading into this last weekend. So that'll just about do it for tonight's show. Coach, we wish you the best of luck this weekend.
Thanks,
in
Mike.
The tournament. Hopefully you'll be returning to Smithfield with a tournament title. Thanks for watching the Mike Presser Show here on Cox Sports Television.